Hello students, in this video I will explain you how to draw acceleration diagram of four bar chain with example. So this is example. A four bar chain PQRS. This is four bar chain. And the link PS, it is fixed, and the length of links PQ equal to 62.5 mm, QR equal to 175 mm, RS equal to 112.5 mm, and PS equal to length of link PS equal to 200 mm, and crank PQ rotates at 10 radian per second in clockwise direction. Okay, so first of all we draw the space diagram or configuration diagram of four bar chain to a some suitable scale. Now first we draw the link PS which is fixed. So this is PS, this is PS link PS of length 200 mm. Now next the link PQ of length 62.5 mm with angle also given, QPS equal to 60 degree, this is given. Now with 60 degree the length and this point is Q. Now next QR of length 175, then from center Q draw a arc of length 175 and RS of 112.5 mm, then from S draw a arc of length 112.5 mm, this intersect at point R. Now join Q and R, and R and S now तो दिस इज फोर बार चेन पी क्यू आर एस, देन लिंक पी क्यू इट इज फिक्स्ड, दिस इज फिक्स्ड लिंक, एंड दिस इज टर्निंग पेयर. नाउ PQ equal to 62.5 mm, QR equal to 175 mm, RS equal to 112.5 mm, and this is 200 mm, and crank PQ rotates at 10 radian per second clockwise. This rotates 10 radian per second. Now the velocity of point Q, velocity velocity of point Q with respect to P, our velocity Q, then VQ equal to omega into angular velocity of PQ into the length PQ. Our velocity of point Q, this is equal to 10 into PQ 62.5 upon 1000 meter per second, or this is equal to 0.625 meter per second. So this is the velocity of point Q. Now the direction of velocity, it is perpendicular to PQ. So this is VQ and it is 90 degree. Direction and magnitude of point Q, velocity of point Q, it is completely known. Now the direction of velocity of point R, it is perpendicular to RS. This is VR. Now direction is known, but the magnitude, it is unknown. Now consider a fixed point. This is fixed point P and S. With reference to this point, draw a line of VQ are perpendicular to PQ. Draw a line which is perpendicular to link PQ and equal to 0.625. So this is 0.625 Q, and this line represent VQ, and this is equal to 0.625 625 मीटर पर सेकेंड ऑन सुटेबल स्केल. नाउ सेकेंड, ड्रॉ ए लाइन, ड्रॉ ए लाइन पासिंग थ्रू दिस पॉइंट एस एंड परपेंडिकुलर टू लिंक आर एस. नाउ ड्रॉ ए लाइन पासिंग थ्रू एस एंड परपेंडिकुलर टू लिंक पी एस. तो दिस लाइन रिप्रेजेंट्स द डायरेक्शन ऑफ वेलोसिटी वी आर. द नेक्स्ट इंपॉर्टेंट इज ड्रॉ ए लाइन परपेंडिकुलर टू क्यू आर, मीन्स दिस इज परपेंडिकुलर. ड्रॉ ए लाइन परपेंडिकुलर टू क्यू आर एंड पासिंग थ्रू पॉइंट क्यू. दिस इज पॉइंट क्यू. ड्रॉ ए लाइन परपेंडिकुलर टू लिंक क्यू आर एंड पासिंग थ्रू पॉइंट क्यू. Now this line represents the velocity of QR, relative velocity. Now this line intersect at this point, this is R, and PR, this is velocity VR. And QR, the length is VQR. R we can write capital R. RQ. This is velocity VR and this is relative velocity VRQ. Now we measure this distance PR and QR. From this diagram it is called, this is velocity diagram. Now from this diagram PQ equal to 0.625 it is given. Now RQ, the velocity VRQ, our relative velocity, this is equal to 0.33 meter per second and VR equal to 0.426 meter per second. So these are the velocity of point Q and relative velocity QR. Now angular velocity of link QR angular velocity of link QR are omega qr equal to relative velocity vrq upon the length of link rq. Then vrq equal to 0.33 meter per second divided by the length 0.175 in meter. Then omega qr equal to 1.9 radian per second. Now angular velocity of link rs r omega rs, this is equal to vrs, r velocity of s is fixed, then velocity of point r divided by the length of link rs. Now this is equal to 0.426 divided by rs, 0.1125. Then angular velocity of link rs, this is equal to 3.78 radian per second. So these are the angular velocity of qr and rs, and this is velocity diagram. Now next, the angular acceleration of link qr and rs. So first of all, we draw the acceleration diagram. Now in this diagram, the radial component of qr with respect to q, the link pq rotates at constant angular velocity 10 radian per second, then the link pqr, the acceleration of point q, it is only radial acceleration, there is no tangential acceleration, and direction of radial acceleration, this is a q, only radial direction, there is no tangential direction. Then a q r equal to r, radial acceleration, of point q with respect to the fixed point p, then we can write a q in radial r, a q p r. Okay, means acceleration of q p, means point q with respect to p, we can written as a q r, simply a q, which is equal to velocity of point q square v square upon distance, the length of PQ, then this is equal to VQ equal to 0.625 whole square upon 0.0625, and this is equal to 6.25 meter per second square. Now AQ radial acceleration of point Q equal to 6.25 meter per second square. Okay, now radial component of acceleration of R, radial component of acceleration of point R with respect to Q means acceleration of point R with respect to Q, radial component, this is equal to V RQ square upon RQ. R, this is equal to V RQ equal to the relative velocity, this is equal to 0.33 meter per second. square divided by 0.17, the length of link RQ, which is equal to 0.634 meter per second square, and A RQ, this is equal to 0.634. Now these velocity acceleration are based on velocity diagram, and the radial component of acceleration of R with respect to S, the direction of radial component of acceleration of R, this is A of point R, this is equal to A R radial, R A R with respect to S, radial component, this is equal to V R S divided by length of link R S, this is equal to point R S equal to 0.426 square divided by 0.1125, this is equal to 1.613 meter per second square. R AR radial component, this is equal to 1.613 meter per second square. So based on velocity diagram, we have calculated radial acceleration of point Q, radial acceleration of point link RQ, and radial acceleration of RS. Now, direction of radial and transverse acceleration, this is AQ, which is parallel to or towards Q to P, and AR towards S due to uniform velocity. The transverse acceleration means perpendicular to means AQ transverse, this is equal to 0. And radial acceleration of RQ, this is equal to ARQ radial, and A transverse of RQ, this is 90 degree. Second, ARQ means this is RS, this is RS, RQ and this is AR transverse. So there are total lines we have to draw, total line we have to draw, line 1, line 2, 3, 4 and 5. There are 5 lines or 5 accelerations, radial and transverse. Line 1, we have to draw line 1, radial acceleration of point Q, first line. Second, radial acceleration of link RQ, means this one is the direction. Next, transverse acceleration, which is perpendicular to RQ, and fourth, radial acceleration of RQ and transverse acceleration of RQ. So there are 5 lines, and 5 lines, and then length of these lines 1, 2, 3, the magnitude of acceleration 1, 2, 3 lines, it is completely known, direction and magnitude. Other 2, 4 and 5, these are unknowns. Now we start how to draw the acceleration diagram. This is very important. Acceleration diagram. Now consider a fixed point. Consider the fixed point P and S. Consider a fixed point P एंड एस. पी एंड एस आर द रेफरेंस पॉइंट एंड फिक्स्ड पॉइंट. नाउ ड्रॉ ए लाइन पैरेलल टू पी क्यू. ड्रॉ ए लाइन पैरेलल टू पी क्यू एंड टूवर्ड्स पी ऑफ मैग्नीट्यूड 6.25. ऑफ मैग्नीट्यूड 6.25 This is this is let P P S and this is Q and this line represents the acceleration of point Q radial and this is equal to 6.25 meter per second square. Now next draw a line parallel to QR. Parallel to QR this is QR of length what is of length 0.634 and parallel to RQ and this is equal to 0.634 meter per second square. This is acceleration RQ radial. Now next from this point draw a line passing through R and perpendicular to RQ means transverse acceleration means this line number 3 we are going to start drawing the line 3 which is perpendicular to QR. But length is unknown. So this is ARQ, but it is transverse, and this is 90 degree. Now, number the line number 5 the radial acceleration of RQ and the magnitude is 1.613 from PS. Now draw P the radial acceleration the direction is radial direction and this is A RS or AR, yeah, ARS. this is A, RS, radial, and this is equal to 1.613 meter per second. Okay, this is the radial acceleration of RS. Now draw perpendicular to RS and passing through this point, draw perpendicular to this point, perpendicular to this point, so draw perpendicular to this line, this intersect at point this. This length, this is E R transverse, this is A RQ transverse, this is A R means RS. We can also write this is RS, this is RS or R, simply R. 1.613, this is known a magnitude, but the magnitude of transverse acceleration unknown. Now this acceleration R, suppose this is R dash, so this is the acceleration diagram. Now joining point this means R dash and Q, this represent the resultant acceleration. Resultant acceleration of QR. And this is the resultant of resultant acceleration of link RS. This is the resultant acceleration of QR the acceleration diagram the acceleration diagram this is acceleration diagram of PQ now by the measurement AQ equal to 6.25 and ARQ this is 0.634 we have calculated, and from diagram ARS 1.613 Now with the help of acceleration diagram, the angular acceleration of link QR this is equal to A R Q divided by Q R, and this is equal to A Q R, which is equal to 4.1 divided by 0.175, which is equal to 23.43 radian per square. Similarly, the angular acceleration of RS which is equal to 5.3 divided by 0.1125, which is equal to 47.1 radian per second square. So this is the acceleration diagram. What were the steps? First, draw the configuration diagram, calculate velocity, given velocity, then draw velocity diagram, then draw first this diagram, second given calculation, third draw velocity diagram, then calculate angular velocity, linear velocity, then calculate, this is velocity diagram, then fourth step, calculation of radial acceleration, fourth step, calculate radial acceleration, and then identify the total lines, line 1, the direction and magnitude completely known, line 1, line 2, radial acceleration, direction and magnitude is known, but line 3, only direction is known, but magnitude unknown. Then line 4, direction and magnitude, it is completely known, but line 5, this is the direction is known, but magnitude unknown. Then magnitude of these lines can be calculated by the acceleration diagram. So this is the complete analysis.